I really love Argentina in general. It's one of my favorite countries in the world to play. I think it's number one for sure. And Cordoba is such a special crowd too. I love it here. It's like the fifth time now. And every time was amazing. But I always love making house and techno music because you have the freedom and the creativity is way different than working for a pop artist, because there you write a song. It's like you have to have the chorus, the verse, the hook, the pre-hook. Everything has to be like in a certain way, and there's no room for experimentation and accidental movements and whatever. So if a drum machine goes out of sync, sometimes it can work like, and it can sound amazing. It would never happen in pop music. And a friend of mine, and I'm DJing since I'm 16, and a friend of mine introduced me to house and techno because he was way older than me. He was already working in a record store in the town where I was born, and yeah, he showed me a lot of amazing records, and that was the reason why I'm always in love with electronic music. I hear a lot of different genres, like it always depends on the day and on the mood. And most of the time I'm listening to a lot of soundtracks for movies. It's like when I'm chilling or relaxing or cooking or something, I have like a soundtrack running just to keep it simple and easy. And I'm listening to a lot of radio as well, and different internet radio stations, which, and obviously now Spotify have some amazing playlists where you can discover new music, and this is what I'm looking for. Like, I always want to discover something new. The inspiration comes most of the time from the touring, from the DJing, and I think all the tracks start after a great night. So when I'm super inspired from an amazing gig, on the next day I have the laptop with me. It doesn't matter where I am, if I'm in the hotel, if I'm in the airplane or whatever, and then I start to get into the right mood again. Really love making music, so there's not a single day where I'm not thinking about it. So there's not much needed to inspire me, because I'm still inspired. Yeah, it was because I was like the intern in the studio, and you have to start your way up to become the producer. So obviously in the beginning you can't do like the best jobs. So you start with a radio commercial, a jingle, and short things where you can show your skills, and then you have to build your respect from the other producers. So, and that was the reason why I started with jingles. It was not that I loved making jingles. It was fun, but yeah, it was fun, but doing it like every day, 8 days, 7 days a week, it's hard work, to be honest. And this is like creativity on point, because then you have to make like, I remember one day where I like had to do, that was like the most creative day I think ever for making jingles. It was like 150 jingles that day, and none of them were taken by the client. Energetic, groovy, uplifting, positive energy, I would say. Housey, a little bit of techno, sometimes weird, sometimes surprising. But all over, like really groove driven and uplifting, positive energy. Yeah, it's life, it's everything for me. So without music, there's, like I said earlier, there's not a single day where I'm not listening to music or making music. So it's part of my life.